Oh, it's great. Mr. Science is back with some spooky new science experiments. And he joins us this morning in his kitchen. Good morning.
Good morning, Larry and Robin. How are you? It's spooky season.
Yeah. Kitchens can be very spooky. So what have you got going on there?
So I have a magical glove on. Okay, it's just a regular glove you might wear in the wintertime. It's a fuzzy one, cotton glove. Over here I have some bubbles and a bubble wand. I'm going to make my bubble bounce around. I'm going to control it with my hand. I'm going to blow the bubble. I'm going to drop the bubble. And look at that. The bubble has a mind of its own. The reason why it doesn't pop, it's simple science. Usually, my hands are oily and dirty. The glove protects the bubble, and I'm able to make it bounce around.
Look at that. Okay. Who knew? Yeah. Perfect.
Nice. Try it with your other hand, and it pops.
Unreal.
So that's just spooky.
What else have you got?
Haunted bubble. I had this giant vase. My wife wasn't looking. I grabbed it from the living room. And then I have this wooden ring on here and then a wooden knob. It's kind of like a real wooden ring. All women, all ladies want wooden rings, right?
Sure.
Yeah. Be a lot cheaper. Okay. Yeah. All joking aside, how do I use the ghost of gravity to get that knob, which is not glued to the wooden ring, into the container? What's your hypothesis, Larry? We'll start with you.
Spray it with Lysol.
Spray with Lysol, that would kill all the germs. Robin, you have a better one?
Just knock the ring out of there, it'll fall straight down.
Oh, I like what you're thinking. Let's try it, 3, 2, 1. Voila, Robin, you're pretty smart.
Would you thank you, Mr. Science? I've been trying to tell Larry that forever. So why does that happen though? Do you just have to pull it out real quick? Is that how that works?
It's the science of inertia, the tendency of an object to resist change. So you pull it really fast, the knob is like, nothing's going on, and then all of a sudden gravity takes over and goes, pulls it right into there. Tried it Thanksgiving time, rip the tablecloth from underneath the set of Thanksgiving dishes.
Good idea. Turkey.
Great idea. Yeah. All right, what's next?
Okay, I have a special paper here. It's called goldenrod paper. Okay. And when you smack it really hard, it bleeds. Do you believe me?
Oh, come on.
Okay, over here, you can put some baking soda and some water, mix it up. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna smack the paper. Now I'm gonna pick it up, and look at that.
What happened? Why would baking soda and water turn red?
So here's the simple science behind it. This is a paper that's an indicator paper. It will indicate if something's an acid or a base. And since baking soda and water, ammonia, for example, as well, are all bases, it turns blood red. Does the paper there at your studio turn blood red? Wait a minute, you probably went to virtual scripts, right?
Yeah,
because
we're paperless.
Because your paper bled a lot in the studio.
Right.
Look at that. Yeah. Wait, can you imagine having him over to a party? Do you do house parties, Mr. Science?
I do a spooky science party. Why don't we have one at Larry's house? We'll catch him on fire.
Well, I'm sure you can ask Mr. Science about it. You can follow Jason Lindsay on social media or check out hookedonscience.org. And he also has a new book coming out early November called Big Science Experiments for Little Kids, a first science book for ages 3 to 5. That's a great idea. Well, thanks, Jason. Good to talk to you again.
You as well. Just a quick reminder, kids, don't eat or drink your science experiment. Have an adult around. Wear the appropriate safety gear.
All right. Thanks a bunch.
Thanks, Jason.